then we get shiny at the 55 or 55.
45, type 45, عشان ديفنا تصوير. تفضلي حضرتك. Lights off. Good morning everyone. It's my pleasure to be here with you in Egypt. This is my first visit to Egypt, so I'm very mesmerized by the city. It's very nice city. My topic today is the use of lasers, prosthodontics, so here's my outline. I'm going to speak about laser alkaline acoustics, laser tissue interaction, the common application of lasers in soft tissue and hard tissue application. First of all, what does it mean, laser? Laser stands for light amplification by stimulating emission of radiation. So the difference between laser and light is that laser is stimulated, whereas light is spontaneous. Now, what does it mean, laser? What's the difference between laser and light? First, laser is monochromatic. It means only one wavelength. It is coherent. It means all the waves are in phase. It is collimated. It means all the waves, they have one direction. Whereas light is the opposite. It is polychromatic, so many wavelengths. It's incoherent, so we have different phase, it's uncollimated, so it's not they don't have the light same direction like the light in a room. Now, in order to understand the characteristic of the light, the best way is to see the wave of the light in the wave fluid, surface of the wave fluid. So if I ask someone of you what they say, they see, this is a kind of picture you may see in Nebraska. Nebraska is a place in the south of America. Maybe someone see electricity, maybe someone see lights, maybe someone see energy in terms of damage that can cause. First, the wavelength, they have two characteristics. First, it is cyclic. Second, some wavelengths are coming together, they are giving a bigger wavelength. Other wavelengths, they are canceling each other, and they are giving no wavelength. Now, what is wavelength? Wavelength is a physical characteristic of the laser. So we measure between individual point of the wave, we can get a value in nanometers. So each laser is characterized by its wavelength in nanometer. So we can put this value on a graph, it's called electromagnetic spectrum. So like helium, it has a specific wavelength, diode, same CO2. Within this electromagnetic spectrum...
I'm sorry, Dr. Aranda. Telephonate silent, please. I said that before.
So within this electromagnetic spectrum is the concept of energy. The highest the wavelength, the lowest the energy. I will speak a little bit about physics, and then we'll hit the application in soft tissue and hard tissue. Now, what are the common components of lasers? It has an active medium, we have two mirrors, one is totally reflective, the second is partially reflective, an excitation source and a cooling system. So the active medium is that a cavity that holds the crystal. So the active medium gives the names for the laser. So it's a kind of crystal that exists in this cavity. How laser work? We have two mirrors. One is totally reflective, the second is partially reflective, an active medium, an excitation source. Once we turn on the excitation source, the atoms inside the active medium, they become excited, so they start to hit the mirror. They have light and force. Once they arrive to a level when we have more excited atoms than non-excited atoms, we will have lasing mechanism. We start by having the lasing effect. So on a diagram, we have atoms that exist on a ground state. Become excited, they pass from ground state to an excited state. They don't stay for a long time on the excited state. They go back to a more stable state. It's called with a stable state, and they give us energy. If we arrive to a level where we have more atom in this state, then in this state, we start by having the population inversion, so the lasing mechanism. These are the different kinds of lasers, diodes, CO2. Now, the light laser and light tissue interaction. In order to understand how laser works, you have to know that laser works by absorption. So if I'm going to apply my diode on a tissue that absorbs the wavelength, I'm going to have interaction. So let's say diode is absorbed in hemoglobin and melanin. In contact with tissue that contains this chromophore, I'm going to have interaction. But in contact with the tissue that contains water, like, we don't have any interaction, we just put in heat inside the tissue, so we need to damage our tissue. So when I'm applying light on the surface, we may have different kind of interaction. Either reflection between the light is reflected from its initial direction, scattering, transmission, it means the light is transmitted through the tissue, absorption is absorbed by the molecule of the tissue, scattering is there is a collision between the laser and the molecule of the tissue. What are the advantages of using lasers? So you gain time, you can have good visibility, there is less need to do anesthesia, no need to do sutures, and also the patient is happy. Now the application in prosthodontics. First, correction of biological weeds, decontamination, gentle recontouring. We will hit all of these tips. Now, what laser to use? Hanga, in an active question, what laser to use, in what kind? And as a beginner in using laser, you may restrict your use for the hard tissue, erbium, for the soft tissue, diode, erbium, and DI or CO2. You can use the CO2 in contact with hard tissue. If you are a surgeon, you can manipulate correctly your parameters. Biological weeds. This is a common case. You put your prostho, you have inflammation, you don't respect the biological weeds. You can correct it with laser. We will tell you how we can do it. Decontamination. So, patient with inflamed tissue, because of the non-respect of the biological needs, what you can do? So we start by probe to find the level of the bone, find that you have some level of the bone. You can use your laser in contact with uninitiated tip inside the pocket to decontaminate, and then you can do some biostimulation after decontamination. So we pass from this case to this case without replacing the prosthodontic, the prostho worker. So, how you can use. You have to make your parameters less than 2 watts. Uninitiated tip is, if you initiate it, you risk to damage your perium. You have to make sure that the pole is pulsed on and off, the same, and with a big movement. Now, another advantage of using lasers in dentistry is for patients who are under the anticoagulant, like aspirin, like Tavis. High-dollar patients, they risk to have hemorrhage when you are doing extraction. Like this case, high-dollar patient, we have deep decay with fractures, the prognosis is extraction. If you like to do a common treatment, you risk to cause suicidal patient more than 60 age. So you can risk a serious damage. So what you can do, you can extract, use your diet at low level to stop the hemorrhage. You can also manipulate your aesthetic at small level. So you can correct this. You can do some technicalization outside the socket for faster healing. You pass from this case, you can put your implants immediately, and you see the healing, how nice it looks. Now, gingival contouring. In case of gummy smile, you want to correct it. You can use your laser, either diode or erbium. We will see the case, clinical case. Gingival trapping, it means you can take your impression without putting the cord, the height. So you can use your lasers in contact with the inside the socket to take your impression. It should be initiated. So you pass your laser inside the socket and you can take the impression. In that case, play more clearly. This patient we want to do, we want to protect his case. So what we start by putting dots. So we put like what on the gum, we learn where we're not sure. You collect the dots preparation. So, هون عملنا ال preparation, هون عملنا ال socket strapping. يعني we pass the lasers with a very low power. Yes, the shaded tip. To detach the fiber from the teeth so we can take the impression with the same sales. We get gingivectomy, preparation, and superstructure. So we gain time. Hide the camera, the other case of the gum is the same, it's not nice. The camera with the same thing, you correct the aesthetic with the laser. We start by probing to see the level of the bone. We make dots, collect the dot, preparation, and clamp. How it works. So it's by making a movement. We don't make a movement like we come and go. We have to make the movement once. Because it's better. You see, there is no bleeding. It's very fast. هذا التيست كمان عملنا له gingival contouring. We take the impression how nice it looks. So you see the pink gum. This is the final case. كمان you can correct إذا في عنا like any kind of unhealthy growth of the gum, can correct it with the laser. هون هيدا clinical case. ما بعرف كلكم مر عليكم هالكيس. شو هاد patient came with this kind of prosthesis. This is the right, this is the left. You remove that prosthesis, you found the bridge. You find this kind of teeth. What the most of the dentists, what they do? شو بيعملوا? Extraction. Yeah. But with laser, you have other option. What you can do? So you can correct first. See the level of the bone, you can correct it with laser. But actually, the scalpel, you cannot manipulate it easily. It's not easy, you have more blood. Well, the laser is something else. You can correct it, you can have this gain of teeth, and you can put like post and core or fiber post. Acetone fiber post is better. Okay, I'm going to tell you that the clinical case is very important. The main character is the crown with metal. Now we replace the metal. Or even if the crown is not a crown, we can use the metal contour on the skin. What we can do, use the erbium in this case. Because the erbium is safer than the diode. Because we need to be, sometimes we will arrive to the bone level. The erbium is safer because it's absorbed better by the composition of the bone. The diode is to cause necrosis. So we can use the erbium or the CO2. So we remove the tatouage without replacing the prosto. إذا patient ما حب يعمل replacement. هون حكيت عن ما نفرستو بس حبيت فرجيكم شو بتقدروا تعملوا بالليزر. You can depigmentate the lips or the gum with the erbium or with the diode. Personally, I start by the erbium. I finish by the diode. You can do it with the diode only. كمان you can remove any kind of pathology. Now we will hit the hard tissue application. You can remove your crown. It doesn't work in the video. So we can remove your crown with the erbium. Why? The wavelength, the energy of the wavelength of the erbium is absorbed by the cement. It is not absorbed by the teeth or by the crown, because of the composition of the cement, it is high in content of water. So the first chromophore that absorbs the of the erbium is the water. So we can remove this crown without touching the teeth, neither the veneer. You can use it again if you like to, like a provisoire or like a compared crown. Also, what you can do in hard tissue etching. Etching, if you like to put your veneer or any kind of restorative treatment, but I don't want you to misunderstand me. You cannot do only etching. You have to use the phosphoric acid or the folic acetylate. But most of the studies, they find, you know, we combine erbium. You start by the erbium, then you do the etching technique, you will have an improvement of the bond between the teeth and the crown. The teeth and the crown. Now the hard tissue application. You can prepare your teeth with the laser. And I was in Dubai, and somebody asked me, you know, most of the time I use the aircraft to prepare the patient feet pain. أنه شو الفرق بين الأبيوم أنه تحملها بالأسرع وهي النظر أنه أسرع وخلص مثل بين البين في شغلة كثير مهمة أنه we cannot start by doing enamel ablation directly. We have to prepare the teeth to at this level we start by doing the ablation. So we start by doing the anesthesia of the teeth. يعني we start by doing the preparation at very low level. So we start by like 0.11 to increase the... Okay. So we start by doing at 0.11 with no water, no air, we increase gradually 0.3 for 30 seconds, 0.5, and then at 1.5, we start by doing enamel ablation. It takes like 3 minutes without doing anesthesia. And it's faster than like preparation, the usual preparation. Only while preparing a veneer, Crown landing, you probe, you see that the level of the bone is very high. You cannot do gingival contouring only. You have to remove from the bone. So what you can do, so you select the length of the teeth. You have to do a level called shiro. There you go. So our step, now we have to do gingivectomy. Now we have the bone, ليه؟ لأنه نحن بدنا نعمل consideration للبيولوجيكال ريسك. So we start by doing gingivectomy. And then you use the avium. You do the gingivectomy with the diode, with the avium to remove from the bone. هيدا clinical case. شلنا الكراون لقينا إنه صار عندنا إنه ما في enough لنسمي يحمل نعمل بس كراون إذا مشيت البون. So we start by using the avium to remove from the bone. We can have some يعني level of nilsip نقدر نعمل هون post and core and then crown. Remodeling of keratinized tissue. Sometimes when I remove you from swallow, topical crown, ممكن تكون topical crown هون كثير منيحة أو ممكن البروسيس تعمل double action. شو بيصير معنا؟ بيصير عندنا unhealthy growth للجام. Either with a fire teeth or on the implants. So what you can do with a laser, you can use your diode to remove this unhealthy crown, unhealthy gum. And then the aesthetic will be the result will be more aesthetic. Come in a whole case of abstraction and abrasion, you can use your erbium to remove it. Another benefit of laser is that you can release the muscle when you are doing to implant. So هذا case of fire ليش بدنا نعمله؟ بدنا نحط implant بالنص. لقينا إنه muscle is very tension. شفتين عنا tension بالمسل. You can use your CO2 or your avium. It's better CO2 to release the muscle. So you can put your implant. هيدا clinical case. نحن هون prognosis لقينا extraction بس حسينا انه you cannot manipulate your instrument. ما قدرنا نعمل extraction لحتى نجرب لون implant to crown. So what you can do, you can use your avium diode or CO2 to remove from this gum, to remove from this thick tissue. So you can manipulate your instrument easily, can do extraction more easily. هون بعد ما حطينا الإنسان. هيدا case of removable to see what you can do. عندنا fibrous hyperplasia, you can remove it with the CO2 and then you can take your impression, you can do your removable crown. هلا هون كمان نفس الشيء بالريموفابل كانوا بس سيبلوبلاستي وذا سي او 2 and you can remove the epiris. It takes like less than 3 minutes. هيدا conclusion. For effective ablation, you have to keep the tip to tissue distance less than 1 millimeter, and a minimal irrigation layer is attached to tear water, best with eggnum. Is that like we don't use water? Enamel preparation. بشكل عام البيشنت موجوع نعمل البريباريشن للكراون نحتار شو صار ليه عم نشعر البيشنت اكيد نحن نعرف يعني وصل ذا ديسكارد ما عنده هايبر سنسيتيفيتي او انه خل ما كثير استعملنا ووتر وات وي كان دو وي كان تريت ذا سنسيتيفيتي يوز ذا ليزر وي كان يوز ذا دايود اور ذا ايربيوم اور ذا انتي اي الميكانيزم انه الدايود شو بيعمل يدبرس ذا سي فايبر كوندكتيفيتي سو ات ريدوس ذا بين Then here, it occludes the dentinal tubule, so it reduces the dental sensitivity. With the eggnum, it causes a dental sensitization, and it reduces also the sensitivity. The best is the diode. You can do also eggnum. Bleaching, technical bleaching. No. هي هنا برستو بس أنا يوم حبيت أحكي لكم إياها لحتى تكون شوية فيروس في الكيس. So we start by polishing the teeth, you put the retractor, you put the solute that the best technique and you have to isolate the teeth قبل ما نحط the laser, there's a manhut, it's like it should be some more in Arabic teeth very thin, very thin. لأن نحن بس نبلش نعمل بليتشنج إذا ما حطينا ما عزلنا الأسنان عن الأكسجين اللي برا ويريسك تو إنه كأنه عم نخلي الوقت البليتشنج ياخذ معنا وقت طويل. So we isolate that from the outside before قبل ما نحط الليزر ما بعرف إذا شفتوني. And then we put the lasers, we start by activating the lasers every 15 seconds for each quadrant. While we wait 1 minute, we repeat it like 4 cycles. Phototherapy also you can use in laser, in prosto, halal. So how we can use it? How she was phototherapy? Phototherapy is the use of light to cure disease. If you are using the light alone, it's called low level laser therapy. If you are using light with photosensitizing dye, it's called photodynamic therapy. Usually, the low level laser therapy is used to stimulate things. Whereas photodynamic therapy is used to kill things. So we use the low-level laser therapy to enhance wound healing, for osteointegration, for pain relief. We use the photodynamic therapy in ondo, in paleo, in cancer treatment. The mechanism behind, I don't want to go deep because it's a wide chapter. So the mechanism behind low-level laser therapy is that light is absorbed by mitochondria. There is a photodissociation of nitric oxide from the mitochondria, so the oxygen species releases with signals to the nucleus that something unusual happened inside the mitochondria. So the mitochondria, the nucleus will respond by increasing some gene transcription, so we have increase of an ascorbic acid base. So this will explain why we will have faster wound healing, why we will have pain relief. بالفوتوديناميك ثيرابي فعلا ريليز ذا اوكسجين ذا سيز ذا اي كايند اوف سيلز اما راح كثير بس لازم تعرفوا انه يو هاف تو يوز مانيبيوليت كوركتلي وذ بارامترز باللو ليفل لين ثيرابي تو هاف ذات تريتمنت هذا الكلينيكال كيس ذا بيشنت كيم وذ ذيس كايند اوف بروستو وي هاف انفلاميتد جام وذين ذا بروستو وي هاف ذيس كايند اوف وي هاف انفلاميشن وات وي كان دو start by doing the profile crown. You can use your lights and low level to release to inflammation in shales. You can use the technique of low level laser therapy at 1 millimeter. We don't want it in contact with any shale tip. So we can simulate the wound healing, we can simulate the increase the inflammation but we have extra. So highly immediately after the treatment, we put the bonding, we put the crown. Low level therapy is not only all used inside, it's used all outside case of hematoma. You can treat it with the lasers. We can put first betadine. Coming on wound healing, high case, you have immediate treatment, you have immediate result with the low level laser therapy. Bone usually it takes like 14 at least 7 days. only the treatment, the result, immediate result, and then after 1 day. Hi guys, this is my team. I'm going to show you only downtown if you like to visit Lebanon. Usually I don't stay in Lebanon more than 4 days. And later is the tools of tomorrow if you can to read it, to this knowledge. And thank you. That's it.
Thank you so much, Dr. Granda Day, for her kind presentation. Lights on. Any questions?